Hi there, Rick here again, and in this video we're going to be talking about home notes in your personal knowledge management system. Now, I've recently restructured my home note in Obsidian as a result of doing the LinkedIn Your Thinking workshop, which is run by Nick Milo, and I would certainly highly recommend that to anybody who's interested in following and learning more about PKM. Now, this is the third workshop that I have done, and I learn new and amazing things every single time. The learnings don't come from the workshop alone, but through the interaction with the amazing fellow travellers who are also diving deep into the world of personal knowledge management. Now, before I go on to explain how I do my home note, I think it's really important to make clear that there is no right or wrong way for a home note to be done, or any personal knowledge management system structure. I mean, it's personal. It's all about what works for you, and this is just my way of doing it. If that helps you or gives you some ideas, then this video and article that I've written will have served its purpose. So what is a home note? Well, if you imagine an organisational chart for a business, at the very top level sits the CEO or the business owner, and this is your home note. The structure you apply to it should allow you to drill down to the lowliest note or the lowest note in your vault, and likewise, the lowliest note in your vault should lead you all the way up to your home note. Now, there are any number of ways to construct a home note, as mentioned above, but in the Obsidian space, I have seen some amazing home notes that have been done by people, and they could easily be described as works of art. Although many people use a text-based and linked home note, like the one that I will be showing you, others are finding amazing ways to use the Canvas Core plugin for Obsidian. And that's another really good way of doing it. But, and I'm sure if you have a look around on YouTube, you'll probably find some videos on that too. So I try to keep my notes clean and organised, and my home note is no different. I want to be able to see at a glance and then click on a link to take me deeper without sitting and studying the note for ages. My current home note is probably the fifth iteration, I'd say, and there will probably be more in the future as my Obsidian vault evolves. So if we have a look at my home note, which you can see on the screen there now, at the top here we have a banner and the name of it. That's what I call my home note, the sponge. I have my maps of content listed, and I would point out that these ones are my top level maps of content. There are other maps of content below this as well. I have a hierarchical system where they're built one on top of the other, and I also have indexes or indices and views, and they're listed there as well. And I also use the Readwise plugin, and I will probably do a separate video on that at some stage in the future. But I will put a link to Readwise, give you some an extra month free trial on it if you like in the show notes. And at the bottom here I have my favourite quote from Theodore Roosevelt about the man in the arena. And you could change that on a regular basis and just put some sort of a motivational quote into your home note on your vault. Now, if you want to emulate the views that I've got in my home note, the data view for the MOCs here will be included in the show notes below, and it's exactly the same with all the others really. I can show it to you briefly there, we'll take it into code, and there's the data view code there. It's really just based on calling tags, and all my MOCs are called maps, and that way it just brings in the maps. And for the indices and views, it'll be that. And then the Readwise ones, it actually uses a tag called to process. Okay, now to achieve this structure, or certainly with the banners anyway, up the top here, you'll need to install a couple of community plugins. So we'll go through and have a look at those. And the first one is called Banners. So if you go to Community Plugins, you'll browse. Up here, you will type in banners, and then the plugin comes up here. So that one's installed, and here's the information about how to use it. Now, if we go to the options, it's then where you set the parameters for the plugin. I've got the banner height set to 150, and the banner style is solid. It also will display a gradient pattern as well if you want to. And probably the only other thing that I've done is if you use a large image, you can actually drag the banner around, which can be a bit of a nuisance. You don't necessarily want to do that. So you can put a modifier key in here. When I've just put this to be the shift key. So if I hold down the shift key and use my mouse, I can drag the banner around within the header. I don't know why people would want to do that, but that's what you can do anyway. I might also mention the banners plugin doesn't only apply to the home note. You can actually use it in any note you wish. So you'll just have to use the same coding into your notes to put the banner in there, and you can have obviously different banners on different notes to suit what the note's about. Now the second plugin is optional and it's called Force View Mode of Note. Bit of a mouthful there. Now the reason that it's optional is because it depends on how you open your vault. We'll have a look at the settings here again. Go here, and if we have a look at the editor, default view for new tabs, or this is what happens when you open your vault, mine's set to the editing view. So I always have that coming in that I can go straight in and start editing. If you have it set to reading view, then it will come in and your note will look exactly like this. It'll all be done. So if you have it in editing view, which I do, then you will need to probably install this plugin. So that'd be go to community plugins, browse, force note view, and there it is, and you can see that it's installed. And here is the information about how to use it. So let's put all this together now. To do so, you're going to have to put some instructions at the head of the note in a bit of code. So we'll have a look at that now. I'll go here and I'll take the note out of reading mode and put it into edit mode. And now you can see the code that I have at the top of the note here. The first three dashes tell Obsidian that this is YAML head matter or front matter. The next line here is the Obsidian user interface mode. And this is the one that the force view uses, and it's forcing this note when it's open to go to the preview or reading mode. The next line is a CSS class called dashboard, which we'll get to a little bit later on. And then the next line is basically telling Obsidian the name of my banner file that I want in this note, in my home note. The last three little dashes close the YAML, and then we have some HTML code which is setting the title of the note. Now again, I will put all this in the show notes so that you can just copy and paste it and put your own title in there. The only thing you might have to do is change your color if you wish to have a different color that the note is showing at. As you can see, my note, we'll go back to reading note, it is called the sponge and home, and it is in black as it is set in the head matter there. All right, let's go back now and have a bit of chat about this CSS class dashboard. If you're going to put a title on your home note, or any note for that matter, you're going to need to use this plugin. Well, actually, it's not a plugin. It's a CSS snippet. And it was written by TFT Hacker, and you'll find a full article on it on Medium. And the link to that is actually in the article that I've written, which is detailed in the show notes. So you can go there and have a look at that and go and have a look at this the CSS snippet. And it includes full details on how to install it and use it within your notes. Now, one of the lovely things about the dashboard plus CSS snippet is that you use it to set up your note or notes in columns. And you can see how it's basically done lists and then put them into columns. So a quite effective way of condensing your home note, and again giving you the provisions that you can just take something at a glance. So that's in reading mode, and on the side here, this would be in preview, in edit mode. This is how you set it up, and that's how it looks when you're doing the editing. But then when you put it in reading mode, it then displays it all as a column. So in conclusion, once again, we see the power and flexibility of Obsidian shining through as a note-making tool for personal knowledge management. Now you can find more examples of home notes and commentary on the Obsidian Rocks website. I'll put a link to that in the show notes. And although there are very large home notes that contain a considerable amount of text or Obsidian canvases that you need to scroll through the screens, it's my view that they are not really practical. My suggestion is to keep your home notes small and compact so that you can take it in immediately at a glance. If you have a whole heap of stuff in your home note, perhaps consider breaking it down into subnotes to the home note, and then these would effectively become your high-level maps of content, which you drill down to from your home note and then further down from there. So finally, if you've set your home note up, you can have it automatically load when Obsidian starts up using a couple of community plugins again. One's called the Home Page plugin, and the other one is called Workspaces Plus plugin. So I hope you've enjoyed this and inspired you to go and make a beautiful home note and work of art. And good luck to you, and I'll catch you next time. Cheers.